today I want to share one very important thing which is required by all the researchers. So this model is my previous video, that is regarding cut in and cut out speed. Okay, so suppose I developed this model and I run it. After running this model, what I will do, as a result I will collect this scope data. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to write here that during this time torque is zero. Okay, when torque is zero, when the speed is more than the cutout speed. Again here also, when the speed is below cut-in speed. So how we will write it? So generally what the students would do, especially PG students or undergraduate students, they take a screenshot of this and go to paint and they will write. Nay, most of them don't even write. Many papers you can found in internet, they are doing good work even, but that good work is not look good because of small thing. Okay, that I want to told. So how to beautify this scope data? Okay, so after this, what I have to do, we have to go to before that, I want to tell the colors of the curve line you can change using this. Okay, and here the size of the curve could be changed. Okay, and one more thing, see here, time data is not shown here. In x-axis, what is x-axis? And that is also not so. So for that, what you have to do, you have to go here and just here, see, here. Okay, so time axis level, so just apply. If you will apply, time is scan. But time is an hour or in second, what? So that will be applied here. See, in seconds. So just apply, it will come. Okay, but what about y axis? In y axis, here it is speed in meter per second. Okay, and here it is torque. So how will you will write it? Again, you will go to paint and you will write. That will looks very well. So what we have to do, just click here and go to print to figure. Okay, you will come here, then just click here, it will open to a new plot. Okay, now here it is very important. Okay, now just click here. Okay, so come here, x-axis, what level you want to give in x-axis, that you can write. Okay, next, what would be the font size, means this 10, 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, what would be the size? So here font is here, so you could give 9. Okay, it will change. Then y-axis, what you want to write in y-axis, torque. So just like that. Okay, so it will come here. Next, see, this graph is look very bad, is not like a graph. Okay, so how you will change that? So see here, here it is grid, so remove this, but still it is not good, not like a graph. So how you do that? Just go here, more properties. Okay, and here you found grids, many thing you can label here, but I am just showing you some so that you will get idea and you will start and you will search best in this thing. So just here you go down and you found X mini grid, Y mini grid. So click this two and see here what would be the lines. I am taking this one. What would be the color? I am taking this one. Okay, and apply it. So just look how beautifying it is. Okay, see how good it is. Now how you will write inside this graph? Even this color of this one can be changed. Color of this one also can be changed. See here, I want to blue, it will be blue. Now I want to write here something, so how you will write? So here it is, insert text arrow. Suppose you want to give a text arrow, so like that. So here I want to write cut out speed. Okay, you can write, you can change the font of this one also. So here it is font, I want to keep 8. You can. So in this way you can beautify your scope data. So when you will put this type of result in your thesis or in your paper, definitely the reviewer will understand that you have did a good job, a good work, and your work is so impressive. Okay, so after that the important thing is, again I have to take screenshot. No, I should not take screenshot. You go here and save it. Okay, anyway, save it. After saving that, just go here, export setup. Okay, if you want a specified size in centimeter, you can put here and you can take it. But most of the cases, what is happening in the journal, they are telling that your figure DPI should be minimum of 300 DPI. Okay, so how we will save it in the DPI of 300? So click this rendering. Here just see, if you want color, you take color. If you want grayscale, you take grayscale. What type of, because in journals what we have to give, we have to give, if you use many color photos, then we have to give extra money. So in that case what we have to do, black and white or grayscale figures we have to give. Okay, so suppose I am using RGB color and DPI you write here more than 300, so I will take 450. After that, apply it. After applying, just export. Okay, and submit it. I am giving a name, DDLG. Okay, DDLG. And here you use JPEG and just click it. So it will be saved. Now this one. So this is. So don't do anything, just copy it here, just copy it here and paste in your doc file and just watch it. Okay, so I'm very sure that this information that I sharing you, it is very informative and it will be useful for you all. So it is my request, please subscribe my channel and share among your friend, may it will be helpful for them. Thank you.